Hello guys, and welcome to our second dev blog. It's been a while since we posted our first video, but we definitely didn't sit still. The past few weeks we've worked hard on implementing multiplayer features. We wanted this implemented as soon as possible so we could test our game with multiple people. What you see now is all multiplayer ready, but we wanted to fix a few more minor bugs before we wanted to show it you guys. Another thing we worked hard on the last few weeks is the user experience. We did a playtest with a few people to test our game and the interaction with the items on the ship. What we found out was that some interactions were not intuitive enough and that we had to clarify interactions needed to perform certain actions. What we did is we added UI elements where needed. As you can see, the cannons now have an icon hovering above it. This shows you what ammunition is required to successfully load the cannons. As well, we found out that users could use some guidance on how to load the cannons. So when interacting with a certain type of ammunition, a guidance line is shown to where to put the ammunition in. We hope this makes it easier for new players to get into the game. Also, the cannons are now movable. This makes it easier to load the cannons. The basic mechanics of the ship, like the floating and the interaction with all the objects, took a lot of time to implement correctly. But now that's done, and the first multiplayer implementation is coming, we expect a future development to go a lot faster. This means we can add more features and actually focus on the gameplay now. We are discussing what type of gameplay we want. As we got some feedback from our last video about the Sky's player base in virtual reality, we don't want the battles to take too long. So we want to give the players a free choice of movement at the beginning of the match, but after a certain time we want to stimulate the player to go to the center of the map, to capture maybe a victory point or get a certain damage buff. This will still give the player a free choice of movement, but after the timer runs out, the center of the map will be a crucial part of the game, and we'll make sure the game won't take too long and players won't be waiting too long in a queue to join a game. So that's what we're working on and thinking of at the moment. We're hoping to show fully working multiplayer soon and publish a test build so we can test the game with you guys. And of course, if you're interested in the development of Crooked Waters, don't forget to subscribe, and we hope to see you the next time. Happy holidays!